I've got one that can see.
How much space do you need to live comfortably? You know, 2,000 square feet is the norm across much of America, but how about 200 square feet?
Pod living is the way to go, Christy.
Yeah, that's right.
Peter Berkowitz says he's subletting, but it's not a typical unit. He turned a space in the living room into a personal pod.
Pod living communities.
But if it's really tiny and livable, that's something special. So an entire trend started.
Ashley Marceau is slumbering away, but she's not in her private bedroom. She's renting a pod with a whole bunch of strangers.
What we're trying to do is housing in the cloud, like mobile housing, but not mobile housing like RVs. Mobile housing is you can have a home anywhere.
There's no privacy allowed. I see you, you see me.
He says sleeping in a bunk with no privacy is no problem.
Hey guys, welcome to my pod.
Check out this hallway of two-storied pods. Each pod was marked with a number.
Storage spaces are tucked under floors. Large windows create the illusion of space. The countertops fold out, the steps double as a sofa. The bathtub is part of the living room.
Because bunk beds are for kids, pods are for adults, coexist without privacy in these redesigned bunk beds that we called pods. It was a 1,200 square foot space, and I had this idea of putting 10 what we call pedestrians into the space.
Take this house, crammed into a space the size of one parking spot. The width between the walls, just inches.
Anything that you do here, you're on display. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 eyeballs on you, and that's how the community polices itself. If you snore, that's a problem. We call them dinosnores or dinosaurs. If you're a dinosaur, you're extinct from the community.
It also kind of reminds me of like adult summer camp.
We very comfortably go upstairs to our pod, and you know, we come into our pod with like a balcony view. You get your own pod, but you share everything else. You can put your suitcase underneath your pod. Everybody writes their name on their pods. And again, to make small spaces even smaller.
Pod, what do you call it?
Pedestrian.
Pedestrian. Are you a pedestrian?
Yeah, I am.
I don't think you want to prevent innovation. You literally write your name here. You're actually a community with names, and everyone gets pedestrian numbers.
You get one plate, one fork, one knife, and one cup. You get half of a fridge shelf.
This may not seem like a comfy place to sleep, but it's actually very cozy and blocks out all sunlight, which makes it easier to sleep.
I hope you enjoyed this tour of the pod, and let me know if you would move into a pod. Would you stay here for 8 months or longer, or would you consider?
Closer to the heart.